Get it?
When you're out here moving, make sure that you're doing you, that you're doing you. You're only born to do one thing.
Hello, hello, it's a Certified Chaos Podcast. It's your boy EJ Davro, aka Man Hustle, aka Mr. Roll Around, sitting on dubs. What's going on? Bring me your face.
And this is Sir Louis, and we have a special guest with us, Big Dog Darius. What's happening, man?
What's going on, man?
What's going on? I'm going on to the streets, man. I am Atlanta Black, man. My name is Darius. Everybody call me D, but my nickname is also Atlanta Black.
Okay.
On IG, Atlanta Black TV.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
okay,
sir.
Okay. That's what's up. That's what's up. I like that name. So, how you doing? How you doing, man?
Good, good, man. Blessed, man. Every day is a blessing, man.
Yeah.
Just one day at a time, and man, with so much crazy shit going on with the corona and all these other crazy things, man, we just gotta really think, like, we blessed, bro. Breathe.
Big time.
That's right. Life. Time life. You can make it to the house every day.
That's, bro.
Truly,
yeah, man. Yeah, man. So, where you from, man?
I'm from Decatur, Georgia, man.
Okay.
Eastside, Glenwood Road,
okay.
Allen Road, McAfee, all that good
okay,
stuff.
Okay.
My second home is Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Oh, okay.
College out there, so.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Shout out to Louisiana, man.
Yeah, man.
You know it. You know it, off the yard. You know they gonna love that. He off the yard, y'all. Go
so
ahead.
My boy straight from Alexandria. I got a lot of Alexandria partners, man. So Louisiana, definitely my second home. So Southern University, Human Jukebox, what it do?
Definitely. Yeah, man. I'm glad you came on, man. I'm glad you came on.
Glad you can have me, bro.
Gratitude, man.
So, how long you been in the? So, what made you want to be a promoter, actually?
Oh man, it's a funny story. Funny story. Okay. So being from Atlanta, you know how it is. Like always, you always grow up going out on the weekends, even when you're a little kid.
You're doing something.
Birthday parties.
Skate parties.
And I would say for the most part, it's the skating ring for us. You know what I'm saying? The skating ring, and that kind of embedded in you at an early age, and then you start doing the team clubs, which Atlanta had a crazy team club.
Certainly, yeah.
So going to like the atrium and aquarium, all that shit.
Why they let us do that shit? The team club shit. Bro, why they let us do that?
We didn't look. We didn't have no such thing.
Yeah.
Like, that's why y'all grow up so fast,
yeah,
man.
We was like 15, 16, folks is really smoking big gas in the club. But that kind of embedded into me. Then I ended up going to college and networking out there.
Yeah.
But when I moved back home, was crazy. Mr. Hanky, the producer, man, a big time producer. That's my homeboy, man. I just knew him as Cord, but to everybody else, he's Mr. Hanky.
Yeah, he put in some work too.
When I got back home, I ended up linking with him, and he was just kind of showing me the night scene. Like by this time, he's already Mr. Hanky, like a super producer. So we going to this club, that club, this club.
He moving around now.
Moving around a lot.
For real.
So you know what I'm saying? At the time, I was working a 9-to-5 job, but I would go out with him at night.
Yeah.
And so I come back to work the next day, and I'm telling everybody like, yeah, I went here last night. I'm there last night.
Right.
And then it kind of stemmed out for me, like, waiting on him so much to, like, I always hit him up to go out to kind of figuring out and doing it myself.
Right.
And so I still be coming back to work the next day, like, yeah, I was here last night, I was there.
Yeah.
And some folks are like, man, you should start promoting, like, and you know what I'm saying, you already be out.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was at the airport, and so when people fly in, people are asked, what's the deal in Atlanta? And like, everybody will come towards me, like, what's to do, what's to do? Mm-hmm. So I actually end up getting fired from a job.
Gotcha.
So I found promoting on Indeed, man. I actually found it on Indeed.
Wow.
The dude I promote.
What?
The dude I promote on this,
say that.
He had an ad on Indeed.
Yeah.
At that time, I was kind of really like desperate, just trying to like get some more bread in my pockets, man. So saw the ad, like, you like to go out. And I'm like, yeah, shit.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Like,
you know what I'm saying? You want to get paid for it, da, da, da. So I hit him up, and he emailed me back. And at this time, this was a couple years ago, he was like, meet me at Mansion Elon.
Okay, Mansion.
So I went to Mansion. Shout out to my boy Will. That's his name, WJB, man. He put me on from right there. And that was 2 years ago at Mansion. And, man, we've been rocking ever since. Like, we at Cafe Circa now.
Okay.
Wednesday and Friday. We got Oak Saturday night. We got Encore right now brunch. And okay. We got Living Room today for the Super Bowl party.
Okay, okay.
And we got After Hours at Avalon. So okay. Wednesday through Sunday, man.
Got something going on.
We work.
Right.
I'm noticing this brunch. This brunch thing really taking off here, man.
They be lit, too.
Brunches
what?
Are dangerous, man. Brunches are dangerous. That's a saying that me and my boy Q Holly came up with it, DJ Vito.
Okay.
He said, brunches are dangerous, bro. Yeah. Every time, like on Sundays, like when I'm headed to a brunch or leaving, I always see some accident somewhere.
So yeah, man. Yeah.
I mean, y'all people be safe on them.
Yeah, but they getting so popular now. And then when you go to Atlanta brunch, they be lit. You know, other brunches, you know, they be in that napkin zone. You know what I'm saying? Atlanta, they be that big. Hey, you know what I'm saying? Just jump, you know, ain't nobody eat, or they done, you know what I'm saying? So that's big, man. That's, you know, and just to see, you know, how that happened, if I'm not mistaken, Mr. Hank, he's also, he went to Houston, I mean, not Houston, he went to Sutton as well, right?
Yeah, he went to Sutton.
Yeah, he went to Sutton, excuse me. Yeah, and, you know, I learned about him from somebody I knew, like, who I moved out here with. They was telling me about him, and then just to see how he move around, you know what I'm saying, and get plugged into that, that's dope, man. That's dope. Like, you always find your path some type of way. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
It's crazy, man. I never thought I would be, like, even here, I never thought I would have made it here. Like, when you just start getting out and presenting yourself, you'll find out that you're, like, two or three people from knowing everybody.
Right,
you know
a
couple of the right people, you know some of them.
Exactly.
It's all about just speaking to somebody, saying what's up, me, I always like spread good love, good energy.
Right. Yes, sir.
And, you know, it's finally starting to come back, man, because when I first started, I was just, I'm always going to show love regardless.
Yeah, right.
So I was just kind of trying to find my way, and some of that stuff is finally starting to come back. Folks like, I remember you da 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 da.
Right, right.
And so just been growing, man, and I'm going to keep going. Like, now I'm starting to host on the mic, so.
Okay.
I'm doing that too, and eventually, you know, I want to have my own spot where, like,
that's what
y'all
it is.
Come see me, I'm on the
progression,
mic
right?
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? And we'll go from there.
So what is it necessarily? Okay, on this show, we like to kind of inform the guests. I mean, inform the viewers and listeners on how to actually do something. Mm-hmm. So being that you're a promoter, what would be some steps that you need to take to actually become a promoter successfully?
Successfully, first thing is you gotta really want to do it.
Gotcha.
Because I know some people that they say they want to promote but don't come out. Like, you know what I'm saying? How am I going to promote this club if I'm never there?
Exactly.
It's cool to see my flyers on Instagram, but, you know, it's also cool to see somebody's store and see what the club look like.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? See what is going on.
Especially now, like, you want to see.
Right.
Especially everything so apparent, you can see everything now.
Especially now, with IG and everything.
That would be one of the first things, like, you got to want to go out. Got to have some type of skill to connect to people.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? My thing was, people generally always kind of gravitate towards me.
You.
I don't know what it is, but I love it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
People can always talk to me, so I'm like, you know, what you doing tonight? Let's go out, let's turn up. Everybody like to have a good time.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
So, that willing to go out, talk to people, build your brand, and basically market yourself, and everything else kind of goes from there.
Yeah.
Building your brand, marketing yourself, talking to people, going out.
So, is capital important, having capital, just in case?
Yeah. Depending on what you want to do, because you get certain moves that you can make depending on the type of money you got, or if you don't want to make, if you don't want to spend any money, it's a promoting avenue for that. You can make general commission, or like you want to be, you know, when you get some real money, you might have to take a risk, put some money up, and you might make money back from the door, from the bar.
Gotcha.
You got, like, somebody big. Like, we had Junebug last night.
Okay. Okay.
So, like, if he generating those folks, you know, that's more money in your pocket.
Right.
So, yeah, it can take capital if you got it. Yep. If not, you know what I'm saying, you can build.
Okay.
You can build, but, you know, it pays. If you get out there and sell, it pays.
Because as far as I've seen it when I was coming up, because we kind of in the same age group, I saw it was a lot of teams working together to promote. Is that something that's still going on, or is that kind of dwindled away?
Yeah, it's definitely still a thing. I know a couple spots that we're like, I'm on a team.
Gotcha.
Like, I'm not the head guy on the team or anything like that. I'm on a team, but eventually I want to do my own thing and have a team. But, a lot of teams still collaborate. I don't think it's as many as, like, I don't know, maybe like 5 or 6 teams.
Gotcha.
But now it's like maybe 2 or 3. I guess depending on the venue and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think there's that many big spots out there anymore.
Cause I remember back in the day, it used to be what, figure eight, and you had Club Libre, and you had all them clubs. You'd be like, man, they'd be the same people. Like, god damn.
Yeah, and that's what I noticed when I started promoting, man. A lot of the same folks was running around in the same venue.
Yeah.
So that matters too, like as far as the, you know, the entourage that you get with, because 9 times out of 10, if you're with a team, there are at least two or three other spots.
Okay.
So it's pretty cool, man.
So like, how do you handle picking your staff and your security wise, as far as, because I know that's very important, security.
Yeah,
very important. Very. Luckily for me, I don't have to pick security.
Gotcha.
Like the club usually handles security and things like that. As far as the promotion side, it's picking who you need for your venues, mm-hmm. and who you feel that strong at promoting certain nights, or like you may have a guy on the team that does flyers. That might be his venue. He don't necessarily have to come out all the time,
right,
because he do the flyers. Like you might have me, I host. You might have somebody else that necessarily bring out all the girls. You might have somebody that bring, that get the, you know what I'm saying, get the people that's buying bottles.
Mm-hmm.
Then you got the person that just generally bring people out.
Gotcha.
So it just depends on your strengths and weaknesses of your team and trying to enhance them or grow them, or, you know what I'm saying, capitalize off them.
Okay.
So it kind of, you know, it just depends on the person.
Their strengths.
See what they're really good at.
Yeah, and you can tell, like I said, a lot of people, they won't do everything themselves, but you just showing you have to have a team in that as well. And see, that's big, man, to turn something that's normally pleasurable. Mm-hmm. You know, you going out to release, it's a pleasure release, to turn that into a business and actually your job, that's dope.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people, man, you know, you got to learn to do that. You know what I'm saying? And then it becomes a business to we be like, man, you went out last night? Like, nah, this is my job.
Come on, it's all right, man.
It's crazy. I don't even look at it like it's
work. Right. Yeah.
Even if I'm going like somewhere that's not like my night, I'm not on, I'm kind of in it just watching the operations.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Same. Promoters, like, seeing just, you kind of start to look at it different versus now. I was just talking to somebody about coming out. I'm like, yeah, I promote. Why don't you come out? They're like, yeah, my partying day is kind of over. I don't even really thinking it as me going to party.
I'm
going to turn up. I'm going to go get some gas, you know what I'm saying, drinking all that.
Yeah.
But I'm really just kind of, I really going out and be chilling, but I'm looking around, watching, you know what I'm saying, observing, and then having a good time.
Exactly.
Doing your research, you know what I'm saying? You always want to know. Right. It's nothing, it's like any NBA player, they look at other players and look at, see, okay, what he can and can't do, okay?
Yeah, I'm looking at, like, who's who?
You know but as you spoke about, like, as you said, you know, you're not in it just to be stagnant. It's about progression.
Right.
So you want to have your own, you know, operation. And to do that, you have to sit back and sometimes, like, okay, this is a business, and sit back, like, I'm going to just observe everything. Just sit down, you know, because if you just get drunk every night, you know what I'm saying, you get to stay, you don't lose. And, you know, you ain't nothing happening, good, but it's some people that really just, I know, in their life, they just party, because it's easy to get, like, you making money, you know what I'm saying, you know, you do your thing or whatever, you get overindulged, like, damn, man, I let this slip my money, you know what I'm saying, but that's dope.
It's easy to blow money in that,
too. It's definitely easy to blow money. Another thing, like when you ask me what does it take, I think, to be a promoter, just stand down with the situation, bro. I've been promoting a little over 2 years.
Yeah.
And a lot of people, especially for me being in Atlanta, and like a lot of my friends that's in Louisiana and Texas, they see me, they be like, boy, you killing it. Like, bro, I see you. But they don't know, like, a lot of nights, like, I'm not selling bottles. You know what I'm saying? But I'm still buying me some drinks. So that's money that I'm spending.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
Just like any other business, you're going to take losses, you know what I'm saying? Just staying down. But eventually, it starts to come up with anything. You stay down long enough.
See, I'm glad you said that, because I'm noticing a lot of these business gurus on social media just acting like they don't lose. They just, I'm 100% no losses. And it's like, that's unrealistic. Even Walmart has bad days.
Right. They have an account for losses.
Right. Yes.
So, yes. They lose. They niggas still out of Walmart.
Yes. Every day.
And
that's just a natural part of life. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You can't get caught in the light all the time. We always cut the lights off.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. You always got friends that
got, right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's it.
So, you're going to take a loss, but just learn from it.
But you know, that's what people actually, you know, that's what people want to see. You know, not like, and I'm not, you know, like I tell people, I'm not an advocate for just, you know, putting, you know, what happens out there. Because you know how some people, they'll feed off of that, you know. Yeah. But it's just like, a lot of people really just want to see that. You know what I'm saying? You can tell they just want to see all this. And they think it's like that because they look on, like you said, IG, they see man, it's what it is. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Then they get into a situation, they fall off because they think that's all it is. Like, man, you're right. Going to come out that mud. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You're going to have to clean yourself off. But like you said, once you stay down long enough, you know what I'm saying, you get to where you need to be. Because as you said, I mean, you know, the field you in, you have to be very disciplined, you know, financially wise. Because you never know, you know, what might happen or, you know what I'm saying, it might be that. You know, like you said, you go out, you know, you're spending because you have to be there. You know, but that, yeah, also that's also definitely the
temptation aspect too, because you are around some very attractive women, so so you know they see the power that you possess, and it's one of those they want this, and it's like wait hold on, this is my how I make my money.